All right, so we said that computer systems store information using binary, so we're going to be working with binary an awful lot in this course. And because there are only two digits in binary, the numbers can be awfully long. The higher the base, the more values you can encode using a single digit, right? Because there are more possible values for that digit. Because binary is sort of the smallest number of digits in a traditional place system, you do have base one, but that's a little bit different. You end up with really long numbers in binary. And so it's really cumbersome to work with binary numbers directly. And so in computer science and in the study of systems, we generally abbreviate binary numbers by writing them in hexadecimal instead. So hexadecimal just means base 16. We usually prefix numbers with 0x when we're writing them in hexadecimal. And the reason that we use hexadecimal is that it's really easy to convert back and forth between hexadecimal and binary. Every hexadecimal, or I'm going to use just the term hex, every hex digit represents 4 bits exactly. And these are the conversions here. So there are 16 hexadecimal digits. We run out after the first 10, so we start using letters. So we'll use the 10 digits from 0 to 9, and then we'll use the first 6 letters, A through F. And it doesn't matter whether we use uppercase or lowercase here, they're equivalent. And so these are the equivalencies. So this is the decimal value, the binary value, and the hexadecimal value. And this hexadecimal value is exactly equivalent to this binary value, and so forth, all the way down these. And so converting back and forth is pretty easy. You just have to do the substitution. If you're converting from hex to binary, you'll get 4 binary bits for every hex, for every incoming hex digit. If you're going the other way, you'll split up the binary into groups of 4, and then you'll convert each of those groups of 4 to hexadecimal. I recommend memorizing at least some of these equivalences. You don't necessarily need to memorize all of them. I personally have a couple of them memorized, and then I can readily regenerate the other ones. So for instance, I find that A and C are particularly easy to memorize because A is 10, 10, and it represents 10, and so I find that one pretty easy to memorize. C is 1100, which is 12. F is pretty easy to memorize because it's just all ones, and so what I find is that I can regenerate the others as I need them from those values. So for instance, if I need a B, even though I don't necessarily have that memorized as 1011, I can remember, well, B is 1 greater than A, and I have A memorized, so I can just pull A from my memory and then add 1. So I recommend doing that. Here are some examples. So you should probably pause the video and convince yourself that these are correct. But so for instance, if we started with 4CA, we can use the table to convert that to a binary number. So if we write it in groups of 4, it makes it even easier to see the conversion. So 4 is 0100, C is 1100, and then A is 1010. If we're going the other direction, if we have a binary number, we'll want to split it into groups of 4 binary digits. We'll want to do that from the least significant side of the number, so from right to left. If we end up with an even number of groups of 4, that's great. Otherwise, the last group of 4 may have zeros at the beginning to pad it out. And then we'll just convert that into hex. So we have this group of bits, which is all zeros, that's 0 in hex as well. The next group is all ones, which is F, and then the next group is 0101, which is 5.